Hello friends, my name is Melanie and I'm here to do a land acknowledgement before we start our program. We acknowledge the land because it's important to know where we are and who we share space with. Are you ready? Haudenosaunee, Mississauga, and Anishinaabe nations came together with all their relations. Living together, they had a united wish to share the land and waters in peace, like one spoon with a dish. Now many Indigenous families, Métis and Inuit too, live here in treaty agreement with me and you. In the spirit of peace, friendship, and mutual respect, we protect each other and the land, which we should never forget. Thank you, friends. Enjoy your program.
Hello, everyone. My name is Anna from Toronto Public Library. Welcome to Summer Wonder at Home. This is our first creativity challenge of Summer Wonder 2021. We will be releasing a new challenge every other Tuesday until September. Today, we're going to be exploring a challenge called Design a Maze. But first, I have a joke for you. Are you ready? What do you call the best maze ever? Do you give up? It's amazing! Wah, wah. Okay, cheesy jokes aside, did you know that mazes and labyrinths have been found in countries all around the world? Archaeologists have found Greek coins with a picture of a labyrinth dating back to 400 BCE. That's 2,421 years ago. There are even petroglyphs, which are ancient rock carvings made by prehistoric humans that show labyrinth and maze patterns. Historians believe that this is because these patterns are seen in nature, like the circular pattern of a shell or the rings of a tree. Insects like ants and the emerald ash borer create patterns similar to a maze or labyrinth too. The words maze and labyrinth are often used interchangeably, but did you know that there is a difference? Mazes, like the one back there, have a lot of branches where you get to choose a path and a direction to turn. Whereas labyrinths, like this one here, usually have one path that leads into the center and leads back out again. Both may seem like twisty-turny puzzles to solve, but in many countries like Spain, India, and Egypt, labyrinths are seen as a path to calm meditation, leading you to relax and work through a problem. Now, mazes are a great setting for stories too, because they are mysterious and challenging. You may have read The Maze Runner, Trials of Apollo, Memory Maze, or many other books where characters had to overcome a challenge in a maze. And of course, we can't forget about the famous labyrinth from Greek mythology that Daedalus designed to imprison a minotaur. For this week's creativity challenge, you get to design your own maze. Will you create a maze with lots of paths and dead ends? Or will you make more of a labyrinth that has one path to the middle? Do you want to make your maze or labyrinth simple or very challenging? You want to start by drawing out your ideas, so take time to think about and plan your design. It helps to think about real-life examples for inspiration. Have you been in a corn or a mirror maze at a festival? These can be quite big and a lot of fun. Maybe you've seen a labyrinth as a painted path or made of hedges at a park. These can be quite calming. What mood do you want your maze to inspire? Or maybe you've been inspired by a little toy maze and you want to make your maze just as compact. As you think about these examples, decide how big you want to build your maze. Did you want to make your maze life-size, pet-size, or travel-size? You can also keep your maze as a drawing or turn it into a 3D picture, like this one. You could use popsicle sticks, string, or cotton swabs. Here, I used pipe cleaners. Once you have your plan, you can work with your grown-up to bring your maze to life. Together, you can look around your home for materials you can use to build your maze, like cardboard boxes and tubes, small toys, empty storage boxes, or even furniture. You can take this challenge outside and draw your maze or labyrinth in the sand at the park, with chalk on the sidewalk, or even with water on a sidewalk. Using items found in nature like sticks, leaves, pebbles, and pine cones can make for a fun maze as well. Depending how large you want to build your maze, you could play pretend inside your finished design. If you make your maze smaller, you can turn it into a game or a marble run. How cool is that? Here you can see that I made a light bulb labyrinth. I use it like a marble run, but I didn't have a marble, so I made one out of tin foil. I also made the Lego maze that you see behind me here. It's a fun game, and the maze walls can be moved around and shifted to new positions, so it's a little bit tricky too. Now that you have seen my maze, go make one of your own. We'd love to see what you make, so ask an adult to take a picture of your design and share it with Toronto Public Library on Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter. They can use the hashtag #TPLSummerWonder. We can't wait to see what you've come up with. I hope you enjoyed today's creativity challenge. Be sure to check back soon for more Toronto Public Library Summer Wonder at Home programs. See you next time!